Hello, and welcome to How to Passage Cells. Today we will be going step by step through the process of passaging cells and the correct procedure to use. In this video, we will show you both what a good student does and what a bad student does. Just for this video, let's call the bad student Aiden and the good student Connor. We hope you enjoy this video, and without further ado, let us begin. To begin, you need to remove the old media from the tea flask. So, as Connor shows, the first step is to remove the tea flask from the incubator and bring it back to the biosafety cabinet. Connor shows good sterile procedure by first spraying his gloves before touching anything in the sterile incubator and biosafety cabinet. All of the tube racks and beakers in the biosafety cabinet were sprayed with ethanol before entering. Once Connor brings the tea flask to the biosafety cabinet, he loosens every cap and then takes out a pipette from the shelf to his side. After spraying the pipette wrapper, he brings the pipette into the biosafety cabinet. He removes the pipette from the plastic without touching the glass and then puts the pipette into the pipette aid. He then removes the media and puts it into the waste beaker. After using the pipette, Connor makes sure to put it in the biohazard box to his right. This brings us to step two. Now that the media has been removed, the cells must be washed with PBS. So, Connor once again takes a pipette out of its wrapping and puts it into the pipette aid. He then removes a pre-loosened cap on the PBS tube. He removes 5 milliliters of PBS solution and puts it into the tea flask. This works to remove any leftover media in the flask. To make sure all the cells are washed, he rocks the flask back and forth to allow the PBS to cover the entire surface. Now that the cells are washed, we can move on to step three. The third step is to add 5 milliliters of trypsin to the flask. This works to remove the cells from the surface of the flask. However, the 5 milliliters of PBS needs to be removed first, or else the trypsin won't work. So, while Connor removes the PBS, let's see how Aiden is doing in his passaging. Aiden missed the class when sterile technique was taught, so see if you can catch what he's doing wrong and remember. Don't be like Aiden. Getting back to Connor, we see that he has removed the PBS and is now in the process of adding the trypsin to the flask. Unlike Aiden, who could not keep sterile, Connor makes sure to keep his arms constantly raised and makes sure to use a different pipette for every new liquid. Connor makes sure not to let the pipette tip touch anything but the liquid he is transferring. Overall, Connor makes sure that nothing contaminates his cells. This will allow for his cells to survive the transfer process and be able to grow in the new flask. Now that the trypsin is being added, Connor makes sure that he puts the trypsin into the flask so that it covers the entire surface that the cells are attached to. Once the trypsin is added, the flask is removed from the biosafety cabinet and put into the incubator for the next step. Once the flask has incubated for 5 minutes, the cells should have detached from their flask. However, to make sure, check that the cells are detached by first looking at them under the microscope. Connor, why don't you let Aiden give this a try? On second thought, why don't you just show him how to do it instead? Connor, first make sure that the microscope is on and set correctly, then looks for detached cells. Once he has confirmed this, he brings the cells back to the biosafety cabinet. Once back in the biosafety cabinet, Connor's next task is to wash any remaining cells off of the surface with media. This will be added to the 5 milliliters of trypsin and cell solution, so this trypsin is not removed first. In order to make sure to wash as many cells off of the surface as possible, Connor runs the media down the flask's side and makes sure that the falling liquid covers the entire surface by using a back and forth motion with the pipette. Once he has washed the cells off of the surface, he rocks the flask to get any stubborn cells off and then moves on to the next step. Now that he has the cell solution, he needs to move it to a 15 milliliter conical vial. So Connor uses a pipette aid to remove the media, trypsin, and cells from the tea flask. Afterwards, he then places them into the vial the trypsin originally came in. If he has done the steps correctly, he should have 10 milliliters of solution in the vial. After he finishes transferring the solution, he labels the vial with the number of the biosafety cabinet he is working in and brings the vial towards the centrifuge for the next step. Now that he has the solution in a conical vial, Connor can centrifuge it to allow all the cells to condense at the bottom of the vial. Connor places the vial in the centrifuge, but before running it, he needs to balance the weight on either side. Otherwise, the centrifuge could get damaged. So, Connor goes to fill another vial with 10 milliliters of water to put on the opposite side. However, Aiden is not as mindful. Luckily, Connor stops him and balances the centrifuge before running it. After centrifuging the solution for 3 minutes, the solution will be separated into two parts. On top is the remaining liquid called the supernatant, and on the bottom is a clump of cells. Because we do not want the trypsin to remain in the new tea flask, the supernatant must be removed. So, Connor removes as much of it as possible without also removing the clump of cells. It is okay if he leaves a small amount of supernatant behind, so he errs on the side of caution to avoid losing cells. He then puts the supernatant in the waste beaker. Now that he has only his clump of cells remaining, Connor needs to put them in new media. So, he resuscitates the cells in 5 milliliters of fresh media. After adding the liquid, the cells are still all clumped together. Connor needs to separate the cells, so to fix this, he keeps removing and adding the media to break up the clump. This process can sometimes take a few minutes, so Connor has to be patient. He will keep doing this until he can no longer see any clumps in the vial. In this case, it's okay that the cells go into the pipette. While Connor continues to try to break up his cell clump, let's see how Aiden is doing breaking up his clump of cells. Okay, let's not check on Aiden anymore. Anyway, now that Connor can no longer see any clumps, he can proceed to add another 5 milliliters of media to bring the total volume to 10 milliliters of cell suspension. After mixing the suspension a bit to ensure that the cells are uniformly spread, Connor has finished his cell suspension and can move on to the final step. Now that Connor has his cell suspension, he needs to calculate how many microliters of his solution will contain 5,000 cells. He will accomplish this through counting cells, a process that is not covered in this video. Once he has calculated the volume he needs, Connor adds that much of his cell suspension to a new tea flask, giving him 5,000 cells total. He then adds fresh media until exactly 10 milliliters of total solution are in his flask. With this, he has successfully passaged his cells. He finishes by screwing the cap onto his new flask of cells and putting it into the incubator to allow the cells to grow. Afterwards, Connor cleans up the biosafety cabinet and fills his waste beaker with bleach to kill any remaining cells. And that's how you passage cells. We hope you enjoyed this how-to and learned the proper way to move cells to a new flask. Thank you for watching, and remember, don't be like Aiden.